Hello, good people. It's me, Kumonawa, your money manager. I have been receiving a lot of requests from people asking me to do another video on investing in shares. Then I thought, you know, let me do something different because I've already posted videos on investing in shares for beginners. Please go and watch those videos. In today's video, I just want to help somebody who is looking to launch or to start investing in individual stocks. I'm going to share with you the 5 strategies that you can use to start your investment journey. So remember, any strategy that you pick, really, it should align to your objective. So before you get started, know what you want to achieve, know your objective and know your time horizon, and know, okay, I'm assuming that you already know your risk appetite and you've selected that stocks really align to your risk appetite and you want to proceed with the journey. So in today's video, we are sharing 5 strategies that you can use to start investing in shares. Remember, I've also done a video on dollar cost averaging, which is just targeted to somebody with small income, somebody who is saying that, you know what, I do appreciate that I don't have a lot of resources, but I want to start with the little resources that I have. Therefore, I am going to invest a fixed amount on a regular basis for a consistent period of time until I achieve my objective. Let's get into the business of today. Let me just quickly share with you the 5 strategies that you can use to start investing in shares. The first strategy is what we call growth investing. Growth stocks. So with this strategy, what you are doing is you're somebody who's looking to grow value. So what you are going to do is you are going to start investing in companies with huge potential for growth. This could be companies who are still growing. This could be companies who are still on their infancy stage, and there's massive potential for these companies to grow. So ordinarily, these companies, because the focus is on growing, they don't pay any dividends. Every money, every profit that they make, they will reinvest it into the business to expand and to grow. So if you're looking for growth, you go for growth stocks. Number 2 is income stocks. If you're somebody like me, you're looking for income in the form of cash flow. Cash flow from stocks, it comes in the form of dividends. Then you are going to go for income stocks. So when you invest for income, you are going to go for companies with a consistent track record of paying dividends. Dividends is what you're looking for. You are looking for income. Therefore, that income is dividends. You see, now it tells you that you need to go back and do your homework. You need to do a little bit of digging. Try to understand the history of the company. Has this company been paying dividends? And what is the trend? And you also need to go into the dividend policy of the company to understand how they are paying dividends. Normally, companies will pay dividends on a quarterly basis, biannually, or even annually. But here in Botswana, mostly companies, they pay dividends twice in a year. So you need to understand the dividend policy of the company. The third strategy is value stocks, value investing. So when you do value investing, what you're essentially doing is you are going to look for companies that are hugely underpriced. So these companies are selling at a discount relative to their intrinsic value. When you look at the intrinsic value of that company, it's really high compared to where the share price is trading. That is what we call value investing. So for you to do that, you obviously need to do a valuation of the company. The fourth strategy is what we call index investing. Index investing, what you are doing is you are saying that, you know what, I want to invest in the whole market, or I want to invest in the whole sector, a particular sector. So what you are going to do is you are going to invest in a fund that tracks an index. But let's try to understand first what an index is. So an index really is a basket of stock measured together. It's a mathematical average of stocks. I know that we see this on BTV every day when it comes to the business news. At the end there, somebody will be saying, oh, let's look at the business news, and they'll tell you that, okay, the domestic index, this is where it ended the day, and the foreign index, this is where it ended the day. So they essentially grouped the foreign, grouped the local stocks, and they're measuring them together. They're tracking the average of those stocks. So that is what an index is. When you do index investing, you are not investing in the index itself, but you're investing in an index fund, a fund that mimics the performance of a certain index. I'm sure we always on social media, well, now we're living in a global village, and we've heard of indexes like your NASDAQ, like your S&P 500, like your Dow Jones. We've heard of all those things. So there are some funds that track those index. So that's another strategy that you can employ to grow your stock investment portfolio. The last strategy that I just want to touch on is what we call momentum investing. So this one is sort of like, it's not really a sustainable strategy, but if you want to take advantage of the momentums, the trends, you're going to go for this strategy. So with this strategy, what is happening is you are going to pick companies that everyone wants to own at that particular point in time. Companies that are trending, companies that are like everybody wants to own a piece of this company, and that is going to push the price of that company up, and you want to be able to take advantage of that momentum because it's a momentum stock. It's a trending stock. It's a hot stock. Yeah, the term that they normally use is a hot stock. So you want to pick a hot stock and you want to take advantage of it. So I would say that this is not a sustainable strategy. This is just a strategy that you want to use when you want to get in and get out quickly and just recover your money. It's not really sustainable. But if you're looking at building a sustainable stock portfolio, so those four strategies that I shared with you, those are the ones that you can look at and pick one that aligns to your financial objectives. So let me just end this video by letting you know that, you know, as we live in a global village, you can really invest in stocks everywhere. In the US, South Africa, Botswana, you can invest anywhere. But your starting point is in every market, you invest through a broker, right? So you need to be doing your own research. You want to invest in South Africa, get to know who the brokers are and go for the brokers that are licensed and regulated. Go for the brokers with a track record. You don't want to go with a broker who is just like, okay, one by night, and then the next day they are not there. They're just in there to make quick commissions and they're out of the market. So be vigilant out there as you embark on your journey of investing in stocks. As for me, this year, really, I'll not be doing a lot of investing in shares except for just reinvesting my dividends. Because remember, I say that I paused everything. I'm focusing on growing my property portfolio because it's the one that can take me to my financial freedom number quite quickly and easily. And once I am there, then I'll start offloading into the stock market, trying to build my portfolio now, trying to balance my portfolio. So that's just me for this year to say, yeah, guys, not really going to put a lot of my money in there, but I'll reinvest my dividends. So this is all that I wanted to share with you guys. Thank you very much for watching. Please don't forget to leave a like for me and don't forget to leave a comment. I will see you in another video.